Howdy everybody, this is Bake, ThyneThroneCraft.com. Today we've got another Blood Moon video for you. This is a little different than the one that I posted yesterday, because in this one, hitting a lot more than just one person. Yesterday was a bunch of rallies on one guy. This one's going to be some rallies, some solos, some wins, some losses, and just kind of looking at people's setups, looking at some hits, see how they go, everything else like that. So right here we got Pickles, who is 275 billion. Historically, Pickles has been a good trap. With the new point system, though, obviously, we were a lot more willing to hit people that we knew were good traps because it's a lot easier to win on points now than it had been. So I set my max rally strat, my max rally lord skills, and then I switch over to my split lord skills there. So you see I'm spending all three types. The reason for that is because we don't know what Pickles has. If we knew what Pickles had, we'd probably set something else up. But I know that Pickles is a good trap. I know that Pickles is probably layered with T1, T2, T3, all that other stuff, because that's how Pickles has been built for quite a while. And so because of that, I'm sending all three types, because if I send just archers at Pickles, he's going to cap me if he's cav on bottom tier, etc., etc., etc. So that's why we're sending all three. After we hit with all three and kind of get a look at what Pickles has, then we'll switch it over and we'll start focusing on only one type. And so that's why it's a little different when you're hitting smaller. I mean, not that 275 billion is smaller, but we're not hitting a 575 billion this time, so we're going to send all three. That way we make sure that we don't get capped theoretically. You'll see more of that here in a couple minutes. I'm going to show you rallies on somebody else where I actually got capped. You saw me type out somebody clear out this T2 with a solo before the rally goes. Turns out I was right about that. I should have sent that message, but we didn't do it. Killed 139 million though, so we won on points no matter what. But scroll down and look what Pickles has all the way down. See T2. He's got mixed T2, and he's got some T1 underneath it as well, 10 million. And so he's got all full mixed troops. So it's a good thing we sent mixed right there, because if we'd only sent one type, we might have stopped in those T2. We sent mixed. We managed to kill all the T1, T2. If we had soloed in front with like a T1, T2 killer set, which is what I've been calling it lately, and what that is like, you know, something with radiant accessories, and you're just trying to get as much T1, T2 damage as you can. Send mixed troops, send strat siege, something like that. A lot of people are using strat siege to try to kill T1, T2 right now, because strat siege obviously doesn't have the leverage debuff that other troop types do. And so if you stack up a whole lot of tier 1, tier 2 damage, you can hit these folks that have tier 1, tier 2 troops for a lot harder and get rid of those troops before your rally lands. And so that's usually a pretty good strategy to use. Right here, we're just kind of flying out a whole lot of rallies all at once and you know, hitting pretty much anything that moves. So because of that, we weren't playing smart. A smart play would have been setting that rally on Pickles, hitting him with the T2 killer strat siege rally, or strat siege solo, burning him out, and then as soon as we hit with that, we send the rally. A lot of people are shielding that now, though, and so you'll find that out as well. If you try to do that, you're going to get your rally shielded a whole lot more, because people want to lose those T1, T2. They don't want to lose their T3. So here we're rallying Evil Warrior. See, 527 billion. Pops his magic last second, but he does take the burn. Barely, though. That was with a 9 million troop rally. See, we killed 9.4 million troops, and we lost 6 million. So we barely burned him right there. And we did get into T4. I don't know what the points on that would have been. It was really close. Now, here is a big fight with AVE. So you see they've got their rally crew there. We've got our rally crew here. I'm setting straight archers at this point because I've popped a dark infantry aura, which for a long time, using archer attack auras or infantry attack auras, the mighty auras, was doing more damage than the dark power auras. But now with all the HP on Crimson Steel gear, that dark aura seems like they're hitting a lot harder. So we hit that one, rally lands, kill 161 million, scroll down, look at what we got there, and we killed a bunch of T2, 100 million T2, and then about 50 million T3. So obviously we won on points on that one. That's a good one, and we got lucky with archers there, because he had infantry and archers. And if somebody has infantry and archers layered like that, what you want to hit with is you want to hit with archers, because they've got no cav to mess up your leverage there. So now I'm going to hit Scout Castle. And here's when things start to go a little poorly for me. So you saw I set my max rally size, set the rally on Scout Castle, set it up with archers again. At this point, I've been rallying with only archers. Speed it in, Scout Castle caps. I go and chop my own hero really quickly so he doesn't get to say oops. Maybe need to not send archer every time. But as it turns out, as we're about to find out, set on Scout Castle again here. And this time I set a split. and I'm just going to basically hedge my bets here. I was thinking maybe he was cav, something like that. He capped archers, so we're sending split troops this time to see if we can find what he's got underneath there. So that's what's going on here. The fillers are coming in. We got our max HP debuff gear on with the rad mag hybrid that everybody's been using nowadays. And we're going to send another rally on Scout Castle this time. 7.2 mil, so it's not as big as we had been sending, but we got the full six fillers, got the full complement of unity buffs. Send it in. He caps again. I'm really quick on the chop, on the self-chop nowadays. And as you see here, this is my brilliant analysis here. His HP is too big. So Scout Castle is built like a brick wall. Found that out. Do not want to keep hitting Scout Castle there, unless somebody with a larger rally size than me comes along, at which point we might try it again, but we didn't end up trying it again here. So now, check this out. I'm on fire. 595 billion, and I'm on fire. So let's go look at how that happened here. Scroll down to, I got blown up online. They're like, bake your burden, and I was like, guys, I'm online right now. And you look at it here, pro hit me, killed 21 million troops. Surprising, especially because I have 1,400% HP left over. See, he sent split gear also because he didn't know what I had on the bottom tier. Scroll down and look at what I had. I had layered infantry and archers there. So if he had sent cav at me, he would have killed my archers. My infantry would have capped him. If he would have sent archers at me, he probably would have gotten up on my T3 again. Here is Fun Inception, though. Fun soloed me, and he actually got all the way in to my tier 3. There, he actually burned my tier 3. Killed 3.5 million tier 3 cav right there. And so if you look at that, even with all my gear, all my stats left over there, and then that's when I started capping after that. And so they kind of stopped hitting me at that point. I say that as my screen lights up red. Look at it. Pro is sending, see how he's sending T7 Huntresses out in front? And then he's sending a Strat March after that. He's doubling that up so that he can try to kill my T2 with those Huntresses, and then he can kill my anything past the T2 after that. So obviously I chop his hero. I stay on fire to try to get them to keep hitting me. But that's the problem with Huntresses right there. See that? He killed 123k. So if you're sending regular troops, you got to be careful, because regular troops swing after strat troops in preemptive. So they're really good for clearing T1, T2. But even if you're trying to clear T1, T2, if you send reg troops, if you're hitting somebody that has a lot of strat troops, it's going to be a problem. So here we have... Demise. And so I'm going to pop my Dark Power Infantry Aura there. Demise is sitting next to me. We've got some rallies set on some of our folks. We have been rallying them some a little bit. But obviously, sitting next to Demise in the forest, I'm not going to just let him sit there and not try to burn him. But I do switch my pets around. So you saw what I was doing right there. Is I know I'm going to send archers at him. So I set my archer pet on my first hero. And then my next two heroes I actually set as my highest other pets. Even though I'm only sending archers, I set as my highest other pets because I wanted that T1, T2 damage. Because I figured he had tier 1, tier 2 troops. Scroll down, see I was right. He had cav in front there. But he had cav in front of T4. And he only had a little bitty bit of cav. Because it looks like he's trying to not get burned. But if he does get burned, he's trying to make it a point win. So it's a smart build there. I just happened to power through his cav and get into his T4, so I was point positive there on that one. And that's how that build works, I believe. He was talking about it in the line channel a little bit afterwards. Apparently he wanted me to hit him a couple more times. This is a couple minutes later here, and I'm going to hit... They've got a rally set on one of our folks now, so what I'm doing now is I'm actually waiting for them to march the rally, and then I'm going to try to burn out their fillers as the rally marches in order to reduce the damage taken by our guy that's getting rallied there. So I hit Muzzy, check that out, killed 31 million, I won the face-off, nearly got his stat zeroed, really close to getting his stat zeroed. Scroll down, see 27 million T3 dead, so we won on points on that one as well. And a lot of people were really scared about how this point system was going to go, and about how attackers are going to win every single time, da-da-da-da-da. Turns out, Crimson Steel is really strong. So here's Sons of Zion, and I think Kane said in KC that Sons of Zion was a good hit. So I tried to solo him even though he's 400 billion. And as you see, my hit didn't go quite as well as Kane's there. I guess he changed it up, is what Kane said in KC after that. So that's what happened there. Here's Pickles again. This time, instead of soloing Pickles, instead of rallying Pickles, I'm going to solo him. Dragon solo, send the archers. I already got the auras and everything else like that popped for it. So he killed 82 million. Scroll down, look at it. And it was T1, T2 troops, obviously. And so he still had a lot of T2 troops left over. But with the new point system, this is what people were mad about. The new point system, that was a point win for me still, as opposed to the old point system where he would have won that one right there. So now we've got solos flying all over the place. Demise is here. I'm going to hit him one last time and check out his setup one more time. And this is what he got mad about. I hit him three times, and he was saying that he wanted one more hit in order to see. So here you see me in, say, in AC. It's a half rally now, because what we were doing is we were soloing out their fillers, even though we, like, I think we lost on points on a lot of these solos. But we were still soloing out their fillers to try to keep it from getting full. But it got full, and so the rally's going to come in just a second. But let's look at the Demise report and see here. Against Demise, killed 3.2 million, 1.5 million injured. Scroll down and look at it and see what he's doing here is he's changing his T2 count in order to try and stack the points, and so that I would lose on points because I just barely got through his T2, barely got into his T4. He didn't quite get to it. He said he had it zeroed in on that last one. But overall, good Blood Moon. I've got some more hits and stuff like that. I'll post those probably tomorrow, maybe the next day. Thanks for watching, everybody. Really appreciate it. Like, subscribe, hit the bell, all those things, and well played in Blood Moon to everybody that played with us.